This is the Chicago 63cc 2 horsepower gas powered generator. We're going to prep it and start it for the first time. If it starts, it'll go on YouTube. If it fails, it's going to go on YouTube.
It's rather small. It weighs 39 pounds. It weighs about 40 pounds. With a gallon of gas, it will weigh about 44, 45 pounds total. And at half a load put on the generator, it'll run for about 5 hours on 1 gallon. You can charge up batteries. This will not run a computer. It will not run a DVD player. What you can do to get that service is to buy a transverter and charge up a couple car batteries. Put the transverter up to the batteries and then put the transverter to your computer or your DVD player. Never connect it directly to this and burn out the power system in a matter of minutes. We're going to go into a closer view of this.
First thing I did was unbolt these two bolts. It's 10 millimeters and there's two on the other side. And you raise it up and you check the fuel line, the connection at the top and the connection at the bottom. Make sure they're secure and the little clips are where they're supposed to be. This is a static discharge. So I didn't want to hook up a long hunk of cable to this. So I took some extension cord wire, female plug, and hooked it up to that. Then I took the power cord for a regular computer. It has a normal plug at one end. It goes into that. In the other end, I cut the heads off two framing nails and I pounded them into this. So I can jam this into the ground. It has to be non-organic dirt and I get my ground. So instead of building up static and speeding up and slowing down, it should run much steadier. On this side, we have the on-off button, reset, and the power output. I was thinking about putting a splitter on there, but it's recessed, so the splitter won't go all the way in. And there's the choke. We'll go around this side. This is where the fuel line is, and this is the fuel valve, or it goes on and off like that. Straight down means the fuel line is open. And there's the pull starter. There's the spark plug. And when you pull the gas cap off, you have a little mixing container with all sorts of mix ratios on the outside. And it has a filter. So if I can get it out here. It's a nice simple screen filter. For one, it's 50 to 1 mix ratio, so a gallon of gas is 128, so your mix ratio is 2.56, the book says, so just put in 2.6 and make it a little bit thick the first time running. 2.6 ounces. You put it in the gas can first, and then you add the fuel. That way it mixes completely into the system. And I'm going to get the gas tank and fill it up. Well, we're out here in the parking lot. My ground wire is pushed in the ground and plugged in over there. Turn the switch on. Choke on. And I'm gonna give it a pull. Well, it's nowhere near as loud as I thought it would be. Let me check the choke. ran out of gas, but it runs. Well, the test worked just fine. It started right up. Problem is, the first one I got was missing the pull cord, so I had to take it back. And then the second one I got, spark plug worked just fine, it just wouldn't get any gas, so I took that back, and this one ran perfectly. Some things you'll need: Phillips screwdriver, and that is to control the speed of a Phillips screw right in there. You twist it right or left to speed it up or slow it down. Next thing you'll need is a socket wrench and a 10 millimeter wrench or socket. This will remove all four of these bolts and allow you to hook up your ground wire to the chassis of this. You might want to get an Autolite spark plug. So one more spark plug. Very, very reliable. This is a feeler gauge. The gap setting on this is between 28 thousandths and 31 thousandths of an inch. So I chose 29 thousandths, which is right in the middle. Never mix your fuel inside this tank here. I don't put oil in then fuel in this. It's best to put your oil in there, and for 5 gallons at 50 to 1, it's 13 fluid ounces. You can use one of these. This is a 10 fluid ounce cup, so I'll put in 9 and then 4 in there. If it's going to be stored for more than a couple months, I highly recommend Stay-Bill. Do your research online, because there are some very, very good deals out there on Stay-Bill. And they claim that it will preserve your fuel so that it doesn't get weaker and weaker by losing its octane for about 2 years. Right now, about 50 years ago, gas was gas, and it would last several years or more in your tank. And they started putting additives in it. There's so many that it slowly loses its octane rating, and it'll last about 2, 3, 4 months. Stay-Bill, they say 2 years. I just talked with our gardener. He's had Stay-Bill in his fuel because he uses a lot of two-stroke motors. He says it'll stay for at least 3 years in his experience. What you will need, if you're dealing with the Harbor Freight, is a bucket, gas container, and a funnel, because they won't take this back unless the gas tank is completely empty. If there's any fuel in it, they won't take it back. There's a little snag in that system. This is a lost leader. They pretty much break even on this. They give you a cart and say, well, go select your replacement motor, and you're pushing it around. It's like me in the auto parts store or me in Radio Shack. I can't get out of there without spending at least $40 or $50 on stuff that I think I might need in the future. Phillips screwdriver, 10 millimeter spark plug wrench, feeler gauge. They're cheap, they're not expensive. Maybe a spare plug. And you pull the plug, take a simple straw, dip it into the two-stroke oil, put your finger on the top, pull it out. You only want about an inch, and just put it inside the cylinder release and kind of swirl it around along the edges at the top of the piston. Then pull that through 5-6 times to wet the cylinder. This is a multimeter. It tells you how much current is passing through these two wires. These aren't actually receiving electricity. They're measuring the field, because it just goes by a little reader. So you set it on 700 volts at first, and you probably get no reading at all, but then you switch it over to 200. And it'll tell you on this screen how many volts that are coming out. So you plug in your appliances. We have two plate hot plate, and several other devices. And you, using the throttle control, after they're plugged in and running, you can kick the voltage up to 120, which is where it should be. And that's pretty much it. It's very simple. If you're mixing 1 gallon, these work pretty well. this comes in alongside of it in the package, and you pull it out of the package and stick it on the end like a hypodermic needle, and you can get deep into the oil can. And that's pretty much it for the Chicago electric generator model 66619.